Thank you, Madam Chairman, for holding the hearing today, and thank you, Mr. Bernhardt, for your willingness to serve and your courtesy in meeting with me in my office a few times and appearing before the committee this morning. I want to welcome your children with you today, and it's nice to have them in the audience and hope they enjoy this experience. As a former governor, I've always believed that an executive is entitled to deference when selecting his or her team, as long as the candidates are ethical and qualified. Mr. Bernhardt, it is clear that you have the knowledge and experience to serve as secretary. You know the Interior Department inside and out and are well-versed in all the issues that come before it. I have reviewed your experience and qualifications. We met on two occasions regarding your nomination for the secretary role and discussed a variety of issues, including my concerns regarding offshore drilling, mitigation policies, and taxpayer fairness. I would also note that we had lengthy discussions about the importance of ensuring a culture at the Department of Interior that reflects the highest level of ethical compliance and integrity. Your record has been scrutinized in light of the great amount of responsibility and authority that comes with this job. I think that's only fair. It is not just about compliance with the law and the ethics regulation. It is about a culture of impartiality, fairness, and scientific integrity. And that starts with you, an example you set for the 70,000 employees, that you will oversee at the Department of Interior. These principles are key to ensuring that a balance is struck between the environment and the safe and responsible use of our public lands. I would ask you to address these issues today before the committee and commit to the highest standards of ethics, not just in the letter of the law, but truly the spirit of the law. If confirmed, you will be the guardian of our nation's greatest natural treasures, a vast network of public lands, including our national parks, our monuments, and our historical sites. It is imperative that all of our citizens and stakeholders that have interest in the conservation and use of our federal lands are able to engage with the department, be recognized for impartiality, and access information regarding the department's activities in a timely and transparent manner. I think that's particularly important in light of the expansive jurisdiction of the Interior Department. Whether it be payments to miners for their health care benefits, processing permits for the privilege of energy production on federal lands, or ensuring the U.S. Geological Survey can conduct its critical work of collecting and analyzing data on our changing climate, the Department of Interior has a huge amount of responsibility and diverse jurisdiction. In particular, I believe that Secretary of Interior must prioritize and balance of our resource needs with environmental protection and fairness for all public landowners, the American taxpayer. A perfect example of this is ensuring the department is working with industry to accelerate reductions in venting and flaring of methane on public lands. We must also examine ways to update our outdated mining laws to ensure a fair return for our taxpayers. So I look forward to more conversations with the agencies on that and many other matters. I firmly believe that producers and other users of our federal lands that have granted the privilege of doing business on federally managed lands must be responsible for leaving those lands, and I repeat, leaving those lands in better condition than they found them. I believe that is a realistic expectation shared by most Americans that should be met. I also urge you to prioritize the preservation of public lands and protect them for the benefit and enjoyment of our generation and future generations as your agency makes decisions regarding future energy production on federal land and on the outer continental shelf. I believe that taxpayers must be protected from permanent damage to their lands because these lands truly belong to the American people and support hunting, fishing, hiking, and many other outdoor recreation activities and communities across the country. That will require vigilance on your part, sir. Therefore, if you are confirmed, I hope to work with you collaboratively to ensure that protections for our public lands are robust and enforced. I'd also like to address the importance of public lands and outdoor recreation in my home state. Beautiful West Virginia truly is wild and wonderful. We are at home. We are home to the New River National Recreation Area, the Appalachian Forest, Cole and Wheeling National Heritage Areas, not to mention Harper's Ferry and so many others. Programs like those administered by the Department of Interior are key to ensuring our West Virginia way of life is preserved for generations to come. That's why I'm a supporter of permanent funding for the Land and Water Conservation Fund. Over $240 million in LWCF funds have been used to increase access in the Monongahela National Forest, Harper's Ferry, New River Gorge, National River, among others. In fact, LWCF funds paid for every single public access point along the lower and middle Gauley River in West Virginia, an area used in over 50,000 people per year that enjoy the beautiful rapids that we have. And just this year, LWCF funds help protect Summit Point Battlefield, the site of significant Civil War battle. LWCF is a bipartisan program with national support, and so I must admit that I am concerned by the administration's lack of support for this program, sir. Furthermore, the deferred maintenance backlog is another major challenge that I think we both talked about. It's going to be facing you and the department, and I look forward to hearing more on how you plan to address the growing backlog problems we are facing in restoring our parks. In conclusion, I look forward to discussing these and other matters today during your confirmation hearing, sir. I believe you are qualified and have a great deal of experience. I'm interested in learning more from you today for your plans for the department where you to be confirmed, and I look forward to hearing how you would execute your responsibilities in a matter that assures the American people our public lands are not just being maintained, but being improved for the benefit of generations to come. So I want to thank you again. Thank you for being here, sir.